Hi guys, welcome to NetGate Chemistry. So in the previous video of quantum chemistry, we discussed about the properties of Hermitian operators. And now in this video, we are heading towards the next topic, that is a well-behaved wave function. So in a quantum chemistry, we generally denote a wave function which we use as psi, right? So the wave function which we are going to use in quantum mechanics, it is quantum chemistry, it is very necessary for that wave function to be a well-behaved wave function. Now what do I mean by well-behaved wave function? For a wave function to be a well-behaved wave function, it should follow some of the conditions, actually three of the conditions which we are going to discuss, that we have studied in our BSc also, right, and in plus 1 plus 2 also, but now we are going to revise that also. So the first condition is that the wave function should be single valued and finite. Now what are single valued and finite wave functions? Suppose I am having a wave function for which I am drawing a graph like this, psi versus x. And when I am plotting the values of x, I am getting some psi values, and on plotting a wave function, I am getting a wave function like this. Okay, somewhat like this. Now what happens for a specific value of x? Suppose at some specific value, suppose this value, I am getting a specific value of psi, a specific single value of psi at any point. Suppose as at this point, at this value of x, I am getting a single value for psi and a finite one also. It is not infinite, right? And so this means it is a single valued and finite wave function. That means at a particular value of x, it is giving a single value for psi and also a finite value, not an infinite value. Okay, now on the other hand, if I am having a function like this, we have psi here and x here, and if I am having a function like this, okay, now what you can observe here is that for any particular value of x, suppose this value of x, I'm getting values of psi here, 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 and here also. I'm getting four values of psi for a single value of x. So this is not a single valued function, okay? So because for a single value of x, I'm getting four values of psi, so this is definitely not a single valued function. And if you look at this value, this particular value of x, then you will observe there is a particular value of psi which is reaching infinity, so it is not a finite function as well. So this particular function will not be acceptable because it is not a single valued function also and a finite function also. Also, for a wave function to be a well-behaved wave function, both of these conditions should get satisfied. That means the function should be single valued and finite as well. Okay, if out of these two, if even a single condition is not getting followed up, then that means psi is not a well behaved wave function. So this is the first condition. Now moving on to the second condition, that says that the function must be zero at boundary. So for example, if I'm having a function psi is equals to sine x and the boundaries are given as minus pi to plus pi, okay, so if I check the boundary conditions, then first I have to check for, this is psi of x, right, function of x, so if I have to check for minus pi, then it will be sine of minus pi. So sine of minus pi equals to zero. Also, if I have to check for psi of plus pi, so it will be sine pi, that is 180 degree, that is also equals to zero. So the function is satisfying this condition, that means it is becoming zero at the boundaries, so this is acceptable. Okay, now this is the second condition. Now moving on to the third condition. Now the third condition is that the wave function psi and its first derivative. It should be continuous. That means what? If you are having a wave function and the plot of psi versus x you are getting like this, that is having some kind of breakage, right? Wave function like this, that is having some kind of breakage, then that means it is not a continuous function, so it will not be acceptable. For example, one more. Here, psi is having a sharp change, so whenever we do the derivative of it, it is going to become discontinuous. So, sharp changes in the curves are not accepted. Now, third condition could be like this also. Like this. Okay, so these kind of conditions are not acceptable. So, the function should be continuous, just like this one which we have discussed here. Okay, the function should be continuous, having no sharp changes. So that way the function will be acceptable. So these are the three conditions actually. It should be single valued and finite. It must become zero at the boundaries. And the wave function and its first derivative should be continuous. That is, no sharp changes or no breakages should be observed in the graph. So these are the conditions for a well-behaved wave functions. Now with this, we'll move on to the next topic. So now the next topic is postulates of quantum mechanics. So one by one we are going to discuss each of these postulates. So the first postulate says that the state of quantum mechanical system is given by wave function psi of r comma t. So here this wave function depends upon two things, right? First is the position, which we are representing as r, and second is the time. So it is depending upon two of the coordinates, that is position and time coordinates. So if we are having psi of r comma t, that is wave function which is dependent upon r and t, that is position and time. So it can be written as psi of r into psi of t. So we can separate the position as well as time functions, right? So this is the first postulate. Now with this, we'll move on to the second postulate. Now the second postulate we have discussed earlier also, so we are not going to elaborate that, but here we are going to discuss that a bit. That is, to every observable in classical mechanics, there exists an operator in quantum mechanics, right? This we have discussed in the very beginning videos also. That is, every observable in classical mechanics will be having some sort of an operator in quantum mechanics. So we have discussed the observables and their corresponding operators as well, right? So now we'll move on to the third postulate. Now the third postulate says that the values which are observed that is sure for an observable, the values which we are going to observe corresponding to the operator any operator, suppose A operator, are the eigenvalues, that is, suppose we have an operator A and wave function psi is operated on that, and after solving we are getting A into psi. Here the wave function psi must be a well-behaved wave function, right? That we have discussed now, what is a well-behaved wave function. So when we are operating an operator on a wave function psi, after solving, we are getting an eigenvalue along with the wave function back. So this particular wave function which we are using, it should be a well-behaved wave function. So now we have discussed what is a well-behaved wave function. Right, it should be a well-behaved wave function, and for a wave function to be well-behaved, it should follow the three conditions which we have discussed earlier. Okay, so this is the third postulate, that is value which are observed corresponding to operator are eigenvalues. So this is the particular eigenvalue A, right? This is the eigenvalue, this we have discussed earlier as well. So the wave function here which we are using should be a well-behaved wave function. This is the third postulate. Now moving on to the fourth postulate, that says that the expectation value or observable, if we want to find out, suppose we have an observable A. So now that we want to find out the expectation value, remember that when we find the expectation value, when we have a wave function and we have an observable, suppose any observable A, and is not following the eigenvalue equation, right? It is not following eigenvalue equation. This we have also discussed earlier, that if any operator is or any operator of a particular observable is not following the eigenvalue equation, in that case we are going to find out the expectation value. So suppose the wave function psi which we are using is normalized. So in that case, how we are going to find out the expectation value? We are going to find out the expectation value using this formula, that is psi star A psi d tau integration. So this also we have discussed earlier, but this is one of the postulates as well, so that's why I'm discussing it here. So basically we have an observable and its corresponding operator is A operator and is not following the eigenvalue equation. In that case, we are going to find out the expectation value. Remember that psi is normalized here. That means, normalized means psi star psi d tau integration, that is equals to 1, right? This is the meaning of normalization. Then in that case, we are going to use this formula to find out the expectation value. So this is the next postulate. So far these are the postulates which I wanted to discuss with you in case of quantum chemistry. These are the basic postulates. Now in the next video, we will be covering Schrodinger wave equation and the applications of it. So I hope so far whatever we have discussed, you are clear with that. So far that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching.